here's what we're going to do. We're going to see how well we do in this election. And I think a lot of it is going to depend on whether we still have some support, not only from Democrats, but also Republicans. But they're going to be paying attention to this election. And if Latinos sit out the election, instead of saying we're going to punish our enemies and we're going to reward our friends who stand with us on issues that are important to us, if they don't see that kind of upsurge in voting in this election, then I think it's going to be harder.
All right. Joining us now is Ruben Navarrette, Jr., syndicated columnist and CNN contributor. Ruben, that was back, of course, in 2008 before President Obama was elected president. I'll never forget that. I'm sure you won't either. But there are some interesting polls out now that show that maybe the Latino community does not view the Republican Party as their enemy anymore.
That's right, Steve. A lot has happened in the last 6 years since that clip. And ironically, now many Latinos, and particularly many Latino dreamers, recent immigrants, young undocumented immigrants, view Barack Obama as the enemy, the new enemy. Let's talk about what's happened since that in the last 6 years or so. Barack Obama has repeatedly been heckled at public events, ended up in shouting matches with people in the audience who say, hey, what happened to executive action? He broke his promise, several promises now, to do something unilaterally because Congress wouldn't act. You have a whole campaign out of the White House run by Cecilia Munoz that goes after to discredit Obama critics. That's a lot of fun. You've got a whole siege mentality that's taken on in the White House where they're most afraid that Latinos won't vote, but they're afraid to give Latinos anything to vote for. So that clip really sounds like it was 100 years ago because so much has changed. I continue to think that if Republicans would just play their cards right, they find the Latino votes are much more up for grabs than they might realize.
All right, well, let me ask you, because you made it sound personal there. What effort is being run out of the White House, and by whom, and how have they targeted you?
Well, they've got, I think, a special place in their heart for me. I've been beating on them for 6 years now in terms of broken promises, a record number of deportations, this cheap and easy way of blaming Republicans for everything, even when Congress is in the hands of Democrats, and as it was for the first 2 years of Obama's administration.
No, I understand that. I know that's what we've talked about over the years. But you said there's an effort in the White House that's run out of the White House to slime people like you. So I'm assuming that you feel that you've been targeted. How so?
Well, I think that, to be honest, there are a lot of people who've been targeted much more directly than me. I think they're a little concerned about going directly after me. But it's an effort on Twitter and on Facebook, specifically organized by the White House, to go after critics, particularly people who are, as I said, the dreamers who used to be supportive of the White House. They're attacked personally. They're called awful names. And I'm not talking about isolated incidents. I'm talking about months and months worth of this material to create a long paper trail to basically try to marginalize people and say, you know what, a whisper campaign, they're crazy. They're run by Republicans. There's actually a rumor out there, a lot of rumors out there, that these Latino undocumented immigrant dreamers are working for Republicans. They're taking money from the Koch brothers and the like. And all these rumors are started by the Obama White House, which in the old Sal Alinsky Chicago way believes that the way you get at critics is you buy them off or scare them off.
Okay, wow. What have they said about you? Anything specifically?
Yeah, I think they think that I mostly want to elect Republicans to office. And I think you and others who read all of my columns, including the ones that are critical of Republicans, would shake your head at that. But I think this is where we've arrived. They want to believe that you cannot be critical of this administration and of this president. You cannot so much as call him a liar without somehow being in bed with Republicans. Anybody who criticizes this administration is de facto a Republican sympathizer. And I'm neither. I think both parties have been shameful on this. But I'm only shaking my head that there's so many members of the media, Latinos included, who are getting Obama a pass.
Now, what do you think is going to happen after the election, first of all? You and I have talked about this for eons, about you've said repeatedly you don't think that Obama's going to issue an executive order regarding legal status. But it appears to be that everything is in motion. I mean, do you still think nothing's going to happen?
It does seem like a lot of it is in motion. What they're talking about now is something that could impact 1 million people, maybe 2 million people at most, and that it would impact people who have been here for 5 or 10 years. Impact people who are parents of U.S.-born children. I don't think that will come to pass for the following reason. I think I mentioned this on your show before. Once the election is over, the funny thing about Washington, there's always another election. And the next election is 2016. And there are a lot of people in the Hillary Clinton camp, including Bill Clinton,
who don't want that to happen. Listen, Ruben, we will reconvene after the election. Thank you, my friend, and we'll be back. Don't go away.